Welcome back, everybody, to the best damn show on radio presents hashtag bet that. That's right, people. I am your host, Mike Knox. And indeed, I spell my name with three X's because like the defenses of the NFL this year, I am hardcore. People, make sure you go to the place that gets you all that you need to know about sports. That is 1340 AM Fox Sports and also 1340 AM Fox Sports.com. Make sure you're there since you're following them. And guess what, guys? It's social media. To follow someone, it's nothing but a click. It's nothing but a follow. And since you're following 1340 AM Fox Sports, follow yours truly. I am loud. I speak loud. And damn it, people, my picks are at large and in charge. Mike Knox. I already told you how to spell it with three X's. And also follow the show that the pros listen to, the flagship show of Fox Sports Radio 1340 AM and Fox Sports Radio 96.9 FM, Soul, S-O-U-L, capital letter N, sports people. This is the show you tune in and listen to that I can show you the money. Hashtag bet that, people. That's right. I am your social media's number one handicapper, and I am here to show you how to win some money, people. That's right. We don't just deal with your mama's picks that I can pick a winner, you can pick a winner to do a show. We all know my daughter can pick a winner, but real men study the football lines, real men study the teams, and real men, and you know, no offense, real women study teams enough to know when Vegas is to buy or not to buy. And I'm giving you that question. To buy or not to buy. That is the question I ask you. Hashtag bet that. That's right, people. Like I told you guys before, this thing is chess, not checkers. Over the last 7 years, I have a 71% winning percentage, winning over 1,169 games out of a mere 1,789 games. You do the math, people. This year, as I told you before, the hardest thing to handicap in the NFL during its season is week one, week two, week three, and week four. But that's okay. This year so far, I am 16-12. I am 2-3 on my locks of the weeks. And people, this week it goes as follows. Thursday night football, we have the Los Angeles Rams favored by 3 points over the San Francisco 49ers. And let me just say this much as I do this audio, not a video this week, this audio, not a video, because today is my 14th year wedding anniversary, y'all. I am excited. I am stoked. 14 years married, 19 years together. And I tell you this much, towards this game tomorrow night, nobody wants to watch it. Nobody, unless you're in San Francisco. Nobody, unless you're in Los Angeles, gives a gosh darn about this game. But if you want to make some money, you want to go ahead and hashtag bet that. Take the Los Angeles Rams. As I tell you, Jared Goff and that defense, the looking suspect between the 2 weeks. I know that San Francisco covered last week against Seattle, but if you remember, I told you hashtag do not touch on that Seattle game because it was a 14-point spread, which we know the number one rule in handicapping is double-digit leads in the NFL on the point spreads are disrespectful, and they're really disrespectful when they're a divisional matchup. This is also a divisional matchup. Home dogs always get the 3 points. It's a scary line, and I want to actually go early in this week and say do not touch this game. Matter of fact, because I'm trying to show you the money, when to play and when not to play. And I'm going to tell you right now, don't touch this game. Hashtag do not touch this game. Neither team has given us enough to know if they will cover this point. I don't have any faith in San Francisco. I do have more faith in the Los Angeles Rams. But it's at San Francisco. It's on Thursday Night Football and anything can happen. So I'm going to say hashtag do not touch early in the hashtag bet that audio this week and go ahead and tell you do not touch this game. If you do touch it, give me the Rams. I like the defense of the Rams more than like the San Francisco 49ers defense. Then we got the game at 9 o'clock in the morning over in London as the Jacksonville Jaguars lose a home game because, listen, these games in London, who they're for? They're not for us because we're not getting up at 9 o'clock in the morning on the East Coast, 6 o'clock in the morning on the West Coast to watch this game. So Baltimore fans, Jacksonville Jaguar fans are going to, you know, get up to watch this game and not really be entertained. But I'll tell you this much, the Jacksonville Jaguars are not ready for the defense of the Baltimore Ravens. The Baltimore Ravens are for real. Terrell Suggs, T-Sizzle, and the boys. Joey Flacco is getting his feet back underneath him, if you will, so to speak. Give me Baltimore to cover this 4-point spread in London, England, people. I love the Baltimore Ravens in this game. I love them. I love them. I love them. Then we have two teams that are the abysmal teams of the NFL. We have the Browns of Cleveland, the Factory of Sadness, the originators, the moniker of Factory of Sadness, the Cleveland Browns taking on the Indianapolis Colts. And this is the game, I tell you, if you want to have your auntie, sister tell you how to pick a game, or you pick a game, you say, hey, baby girl, who you got winning this game? This is a game for them to pick, because hashtag do not touch this game. The Cleveland Bungles taking on the Indianapolis Colts in Indianapolis. I mean, if I got to pick this game, I'm going to tell you again, hashtag do not touch this game as well. But since you're asking and you're listening, go ahead and give me the Cleveland Bungles to cover the 1-point pick'em game. Then we got the Pittsburgh Steelers going to the Windy City to take on a team that's getting back a receiver, getting back an offensive lineman. They got the rumblings in the locker room that they want Mitch Trubisky to start over Mike Glennon. Give me the team I picked to go to the AFC Championship game. Give me the team I picked to go to the Super Bowl last year. Give me Ben Roethlisberger. Give me Bell. Give me the Killer Bees to win this game and cover the 8 points. Give me Pittsburgh all day, son. Then we got the Miami Dolphins going up in the divisional matchup to play the New York Jets in New York City. The Jets are tanking the same way the Boston Celtics tanked. The New York Jets are tanking the same way the 76ers tanked. So because they're tanking, and honestly, I just like Miami. I like the Miami Dolphins defense. I like the Miami Dolphins offense. I like Joe Adai against that defense of the Jets, who is not as bad as people think, but give me the Miami Dolphins to cover the 6 points. Then we got the team who I told last week in my lock of the week, the upset lock of the week, the Denver Broncos, or as Homer Simpson would say, oh, the Denver Broncos. Give me the Denver Broncos at 3 going to Buffalo, a West Coast team, or in this case, a Mountain Central team, going east to play the Buffalo Bills. Sorry, Shady. You will have a shady day in Buffalo as the defense of the Denver Broncos will shine through. And the offense, people, of Denver needs to have some respect. Sanders, Anderson, the quarterback play from the Denver Broncos has just been what it needs to do. Is he quarterback managing the game? Maybe. But that defense is so good with those corners, that secondary, and that front four, it's working out for them. Shout out to my man, the best quarterback I believe ever in NFL history, John Elway, putting together another brilliant team. Give me Denver to cover the 3 against the Buffalo Bills. Then we have, again, double-digit leads in the NFL are disrespectful. But I made a rule last week that says Tom Brady always covers. The New England Patriots at home against the Houston Texans, favored by 14 points. I like Houston to cover, but I like the rules that I come up with and say New England can cover the 14. Houston's defense is top-notch defense. New England struggled with them last year, oh, so people thought, and whooped them on Thursday Night Football with backups in the game. You remember that game, Jacoby Brissett? Yeah, now where he's at. He's in Indianapolis. But now they got Brady, 14 points. I'm stumbling, fumbling, rumbling to find out who I'm going to pick. Hashtag, give me the rule breaker that I cannot be Houston to cover the 14 points. Again, hashtag, when points are this high, you stay away from them unless you're on a teaser. If you're on a teaser pick, on a parlay, then you might want to take it because you got outlandish, if you will, so to speak, point spreads anyway. Then you would take New England, but I'm saying hashtag do not touch this game. If you do, give me the Houston Texans to cover the 14 points when New England will win this game. Then we got Carolina struggling offense, Cam Newton. They're winning. They're 2-0, but they're struggling. New Orleans, 0-2, but they're struggling. A divisional matchup that always is a very good matchup in the NFC South. Carolina favored by 6 at home against New Orleans. I'm going to trust you, Carolina. I'm going to trust Super Cam that he's knocking off the rust. But when you got Breeze on the other side, you got an angry Adrian Peterson, you got a motivated Sean Payton, I'm still going to take Carolina and the six. Then we got Tampa Bay off of the debauch, the debacle, the eradication of the Chicago Bears last week in their first game as they are in number two games of 16 straight, favored by 4 points on the road against Minnesota. I like Minnesota. The over-under in this game is on off right now. There is no score for the over-under. Minnesota with Sam Bradford looks good. But do we know if Sam Bradford's going to play? As of right now, give me Tampa Bay to cover the 4 points. I like famous Jameis Winston and that defense. I picked them to win the AFC South. No, actually, I picked them to be a wild card this year, but still, you get my point. But the team I picked to win the AFC South, the Atlanta Falcons, favored by the two undefeated teams against the Detroit Lions, on the road in Detroit, favored by 3 points. I'm going to be honest with you guys. I don't think Detroit can stay with this Atlanta offense. Give Atlanta to cover the three. Then we got the Eagles of Philadelphia, favored by 6 over the Giants of New York City, a divisional matchup, the real hatred rivalry. It's not the Eagles and the Cowboys. It's not the Giants and the Cowboys. It's the Philadelphia Eagles versus the New York Football Giants. The miracle in the Meadowlands happened not once, but two times. It will not happen in Philadelphia. Give me Carson Wentz. Give me Doug Peterson to run the football this game. Give me the Philadelphia Eagles to cover the 6 points at home in their home opener. Then we got Tennessee favored by 3 points over Seattle. Woo-wee! Go back for 1 second. Give me the lock of the week as the Philadelphia Eagles will lock up the New York Football Giants this week. That's right. Give me the Philadelphia Eagles to cover that 6 points and lock it up. And then we got the game that you got to have balls to call. You're going to have so many balls in this game that LeBron James can't catch a break. Give me the Tennessee Titans, who are favored in this game against Seattle, to win the game against the Seattle Seahawks and cover the 3 points. Tennessee, this is a make or break game for you. I'm going to make or break my picks with you and give me Tennessee to cover and lock it up. Tennessee will beat and cover the Seattle Seahawks. Then we got Kansas City going on the road against the Los Angeles Chargers. And again, it's always down to the wire. Kansas City's playing wonderful. Andy Reid is making plays and doing things that he has done for 15 years. And people still can't figure him out. Give me Andy Reid and the Kansas City Chiefs to cover the 3 points against the Chargers on the road. Then we got the Packers of Green Bay, favored by 9 points over the Cincinnati Bengals. Listen, Cincinnati has no offense. Cincinnati, I repeat, has no offense. Give me the baddest man on the planet, Aaron Rodgers, to cover the 9 points at home against the Bengals. Then we got the Oakland Raiders going to the West Coast, the Sunday night game of the week, taking on the Washington Redskins, favored by 3 points on the road. Listen, if you don't like Marshawn Lynch dancing, then stop him from getting in the end zone. Give me the Oakland Raiders to beat the Washington Redskins by 3 points. I think that defense, I think that offense is too much for Kirk Cousins. You like that? And the boys. Then we got Dallas favored by 3 points over Arizona. Arizona people are not who they used to be. The defense is still a solid defense, but they're just offensively are not the same team. You have to have some offense in the NFL, no matter what people say. Yes, we know defense wins championships, but offense sells tickets. Give me the Dallas Cowboys to go to 2-1 and beat the Arizona Cardinals this week, people. There you have it. I'm looking for the upset that I have here, and I got to call one, but I'm going to run them back here from bottom to top, top to bottom, because we're here. Give me Dallas over Arizona. Give me Oakland over Washington. Give me Green Bay over Cincinnati. Give me Kansas City over LA. Give me Tennessee lock of the week over Seattle. Give me my other lock of the week, Philadelphia over New York by 6. Give me Atlanta over Detroit. Give me Tampa Bay over Minnesota. Give me Carolina over New Orleans. Give me the hashtag do not touch game. Give me Houston. Matter of fact, there's my upset of the week. Give me Houston to cover that 14-point spring spread against New England. New England might win by 13. They might win by 10. I'm just hoping the defense of Houston can keep in this game. And I know you're sexing yourself. You do remember last time they played, right? But it's a rule I have. When there's a double-digit point spread in the NFL, it doesn't typically work out. Although last week it worked out 1-1. Let's see what happens this week. Give me Houston to cover that. Then we got Denver over Buffalo, Miami over the Jets, Pittsburgh over Chicago, Cleveland over Indianapolis, Baltimore over Jacksonville, and the Rams over San Francisco. I pretty much have all the favorites winning this week. This is a very, I'm believing for my come out week of this year, guys, is right here, week three. Again, top to bottom, give me the Rams, give me Baltimore, give me Cleveland, give me Pittsburgh, give me Miami, give me Denver, give me Houston, my only upset to cover this week. Give me Carolina, Tampa Bay, Atlanta, Philadelphia, Tennessee, Kansas City, the Packers of Green Bay, the Raiders of Oakland, and the Dallas Cowboys. People, there you have it. Hashtag bet that. It's my anniversary, and I'm going to go do some things. We have to make animal noises, y'all, like Ricky Bobby. I'll see y'all next week, y'all. Peace.